Plastic. Although it has existed for only 50 years, its mere existence is almost inescapable. Plastic production has grown from 15 million tons in 1964 to 311 million tons in 2014, and is only expected to double over the next 20 years and quadruple by 2050. It's a term that almost everyone knows because it's in everything and almost everywhere, from the phones we use to update our friends and family to the takeout we get our food in. Although it makes our lives easier, it does this at a cost, a serious and long-lasting cost. It can take hundreds and hundreds of years for plastic to degrade, but even then it breaks into these tiny pieces known as microplastics. So in reality, it never really leaves this planet. So chances are almost every toothbrush, pen, plastic water bottle, and plastic coffee cup you have ever used is still on this earth, contributing to plastic pollution. So even though it might take you less than 3 minutes to gulp down water from a plastic water bottle after a workout, it takes the earth 450 years to break down. As you can imagine, plastic destroys our planet Earth. The manufacturing of plastic increases greenhouse gas emissions, which lead to global warming and climate change. In addition, it pollutes our oceans, harms our animals, and destroys our ecosystem. Plastic is taking over the habitat of sea animals, such as fishes. In fact, each year, at least 8 million tons of plastic leak into the ocean. To put into perspective, this is equal to one garbage truck dumping its contents into the ocean each minute. Research indicates that by 2050, the volume of plastic in the oceans will be more than the fish present itself. In fact, more than 80% of litter in the sea is plastic, which is estimated to kill about 1 million seabirds and 100,000 sea creatures each year. We're not immune to the harmful effects either. Remember, it impacts the entire ecosystem. Researchers indicate that we are consuming 5 grams of plastic per week, which comes in the form of microplastics from our tap water, plastic water bottles, and through our food sources. As expected, just like anything else we consume or drink, it makes its way throughout our body and eventually through our blood. Given the toxic chemicals in plastic, we are at risk of developing cancer and other diseases. But what if we said these environmental and health impacts could be put to a stop by a new, renewable, and biodegradable solution? What if there was a way to a safer alternative? Believe it or not, there is.
Before we look into the alternatives to plastic, it is important to go over the timeline of plastic's evolution, especially the evolution of our own thinking when it comes to plastic. In 1950, there was a massive shift in plastic consumption as it was introduced to the food sector. In 1970, single-use plastic bags were introduced, but little did the inventors know that plastic would become one of the most significant burdens when it comes to pollution. And it wasn't until 1990 did researchers discover that plastic was polluting our oceans and ruining our ecosystems. By 2010, people were more aware of the negative effects of plastic on our environment, and we began to see efforts in mitigating the issue of plastic pollution. By 2020 and beyond, we have started getting somewhere with innovations for alternatives to plastic. Therefore, let's do a quick overview of the past solutions and alternatives scientists have come up in the past decade or so. Over the past few years, scientists have attempted to mitigate plastic pollution. Past solutions such as using less plastic or recycling it more are simply just not as futile, as plastic is an inescapable part of our modern everyday life. Instead, we should be focusing on ways to create an alternative for plastic that is tough and durable enough to work for use, but is still degradable when deposited in nature, and is made up of naturally abundant materials. However, most of the attempts were rendered unsuccessful as scientists failed to create an alternative that has properties close to conventional plastic. That is, until a study in 2016 conducted in Switzerland inspired a new breakthrough into solving the issue of plastic pollution. The 2016 study discovered how to make use of the inedible parts of plants to make plastic. However, their attempts failed as their process requires formaldehyde, an organic compound known for its toxic and carcinogenic effects. This study still proved to be helpful, as a new 22 study published by Nature Chemistry expanded on that research to find a more suitable alternative. Instead of using formaldehyde because of its known toxic effects, they used an alternative called glycoxylic acid because they realized it was a safe compound able to convert even more of the plant waste into plastic than the formaldehyde previously used. Furthermore, unlike the previous failed alternatives to plastics scientists have come up with, this new alternative has properties that are so close to the conventional plastic we use. It is strong, blocks gases, and can resist high temperatures.
They combine this glyoxylic acid with lignin to make the durable, biodegradable, and abundant plastic. But what is lignin? Lignin is a plant-based molecule. It is produced from plant cell walls, and it's a molecule mostly responsible for making plants stiff. Lignin is the second largest biomass in nature, and it is frequently derived from the paper industry. To make the bioplastic, lignin and a biopolymer such as starch or protein are blended together to make a strong bioplastic that is both cost and water efficient. Most bioplastics are made with a starch biopolymer, since it is widely available, cheap, renewable, and biodegradable without the risk of toxic residues being formed. However, some weaknesses of a starch polymer are the low water resistance and strength. By combining lignin with a starch biopolymer, the bioplastic becomes water-resistant and strong due to the hydrophobic and durable nature of lignin. This, along with the previously mentioned benefits, makes an ideal bioplastic that can be used for a variety of things. Lignin has been used to create a variety of things already, such as packaging film, fibers that are used for fabrics, and 3D printing filaments. Lignin plastic provides extra benefits that regular plastics could not. For example, for packaging films, there is the added benefit of improved UV shielding and water and oxygen resistant properties, which allows packages to remain in quality condition.
So, how is this plastic special enough to be able to solve the issue of plastic pollution? Well, to begin with, there would be no more non-recyclable plastic sitting in our oceans. Plastic made by plant parts would fully disintegrate into its constituent sugars in room temperature water. Those sugars can then be utilized by the ecosystem and all of the sea creatures who can feed on those sugars. On top of that, this new plastic is estimated to have 71% lower associated greenhouse emissions as compared to conventional plastic. Therefore, it could help mitigate the effects of climate change as well.
This plastic alternative is also very feasible, since the main materials used to make it are very accessible. A mineral acid is used as a catalyst for binding, and glyoxylic acid is one of the building blocks. Both these materials exist in large quantities and are cheap and readily available in nature. Because of this, the manufacturing process is also very simple and scalable. This is really comparable to the current plastic production process, making it a great environmentally friendly option. Before we can introduce this new method of eco-friendly plastic production, we still need all the data on its long-term effects on the environment. Two tests are still required: toxicological and biodegradation tests. A toxicological test will determine if it releases any toxins over a long period of time, and a biodegradation test will tell us how this material will break down in the environment. Once we know the long-term effects are not harmful, we can begin the production of this process.